Welcome to the Brick House, aka Supreme Week 11. Yeah, that's right. We are in Supreme Week 11 of this fall-winter 19 season. And man, it's a brick week. I'm sorry to just like slap that right on you. Like, hey, this week's trash. There you go. Have a good day. But no, there's a few things that are actually kind of firing this week. But before we get to that, that drop list, dude, Supreme screwed me over this week. I've never had this happen or heard about anybody else having this problem. If you understand what I'm talking about, comment down below, like, if this is, like, normal. I have no idea. So, last week was North Face. I was gonna go for the jacket, mountain jacket, but I was like, $400, kind of pricey. I just want a personal. I was gonna cop the white tee. It was like $50 with tax and everything. It'd be like 60 or 70. No big deal. And I'll keep in the collection, whatever. It's fire. So I get on. Easy cop. Literally not even a problem. I get onto my email and I have two order numbers. Like different emails. And I was like, what the heck? So on the screen, let's just say the last two numbers were like 22. All right, of my order. All right, so on my screen, I have the picture, like literally is legit, order number 22. I get to my email and I have an order number that ends in 22 and then another order number that ends in 25 with the same exact thing, like the t-shirt, medium, white, everything. So I email Supreme, which is probably what I shouldn't have done this, but I emailed Supreme and I was like, hey, like I got two order numbers. I checked my bank account. I only got charged for the one. I probably shouldn't have said that. Maybe I would have gotten a free shirt. I don't know. They respond back an hour later. Supreme has canceled your order. I'm like, okay, well, they just canceled the one shirt that I may have gotten for free, but who knows? I checked my account. Payment's gone. So I was like, wait, so I actually paid for the one that ended in 25, not 22, and I thought 22 was the one that I paid for. It was so confusing. Then I ended up getting charged again for the 22 order, but then I emailed, like, I was like, shipping, anything, and they just canceled that. Like, it just, like, got... It was pending on my account, and then it just got deleted. So, I don't know what happened. I'm kind of salty, because this shirt is fire, and I really wanted it. But, it is what it is. And this week, I mean, doesn't bring any joy to me at all. So, we're just going to go through this week. Strap list. We're going to go over... I don't have any retail prices, because we just don't have them, and I want to get this video out. And so, that's going to affect the resell predictions, because I don't really have any idea. But mostly overall, there really isn't anything to go for. And prices, I'll try to estimate, but I don't really know that much when it comes to like the retails, because like what a normal shirt for me, I would think Supreme is like twice the amount, you know what I'm saying? So we're just gonna go through the items and then I'll retweet the drop list prices if they come out, you know, before the drop, obviously, so you can check there. But we're gonna start at the bottom, which I do have the prices for, because these came like, news about these came out earlier, and that is the Supreme Nike Air Max 95 Lux, coming in three colorways for $500. That's right. These Nikes are trash. These are literally the most garbage things I've ever seen. The colorways are ugly. The black's all right, but the red and blue, literally clown shoes. Like, what are you wearing? And they're supposed to be made in Italy, like, you know, fancy leather, whatever, for $500, and this is just not it. Like, I don't see anyone paying $500 for these. I mean, yeah, you'll get the people who are like hype beasts and whatever and wear them, but you can just put, if you see anybody post a picture in them, just comment the clown emoji, because they're clowns. Like, this is trash. Then we got the floral stripe carnigan coming in two colorways, and this is fantastic. If you don't know what to get your grandpa for Christmas, then there you go. You can get him the Supreme floral carnigan. Honestly, I think it's trash. I've seen a lot of people like this, and we have seen carnigans actually pop off, but for this one, I just don't see it happening. I don't know the retail, or I don't really have a resale prediction because I don't think it is going to resell, but some people like this. I personally think it's a grandpa. Like, it just looks old and dumb, so not going for that. Then we have the 1-800 Buffalo plaid shirt coming in three colorways, and this one's not bad. The only thing that's super annoying is that, like, dumb patch thing on the bottom. Like, I don't know even know what it says. But that's super annoying, and on the back it says 1-800-SUPREME, which honestly is not bad. I kind of dig that, especially in the black and white. I was like, hey, that's kind of fire. But it is a wool flannel, so this John will probably be like $140, something ridiculous, coming from Supreme. So there's not going to be any resell there. Then we have the Mindful top coming in three colorways. And this is just another poor design. Like, literally, this looks like something from Zumiez. Just basic. It has no Supreme branding. Doesn't make any sense. Just, I mean, it's just garbage. Then we have the Speckle Stripe Beanie coming in four colorways. And again, it's another beanie that's just so trash. First off, the stripe thing is just basic and lame. Second off, the colors are horrible. Like, what is that purple and blue, black and is it red and brown? What is that colorway? Literally garbage. And then they just added like lint all over it, like all these little speckles. That literally looks like a beanie that someone wore for like 3 years. It's like their favorite beanie, and it's got all those little like little balls of the stitching on there, and it just looks so dumb. Like, it literally just looks like, oh my god, I can't with this. It's so trash. Then we have the Bow Waffle Thermal coming in two colorways, and this is just like cute, I guess. I don't know. It has a bunch of little pink bows, and it says Supreme under it. I don't think I would wear this. I mean, I kind of would. Here's how I would wear it. If it was the breast cancer little bow thing, then I would buy it because that's clean. Like, that'd be so sick. But it's not. It's like a little girl bow. So I guess you got to get this for your girl for Christmas. I don't know. It's up to you. You know you're a woman. I don't. Maybe she wants this. Maybe you want this. Maybe you could both get it. I don't know. Who cares? No resale. Then we have the Panel Warm-Up Pants coming in five colorways. And these are just... they're not bad. I kind of like the little Supreme on the waistband, but I'm not a pant person from Supreme. There's no real reason for me to get these. I don't see resale being a thing for these, so you can just let them go. Then we have this HQ type thing, and I'll tell you more about it, but it pretty much is like a whole collection. And so it's the New Air HQ beanie coming in a ton of colorways. I think we have eight there. Eight there. So it pretty much just has the address, the phone number, everything for the Tokyo headquarters of Supreme in Japan, which is kind of sick. On a beanie, not it for me. I don't like it. It's too much writing. It's too much. But I'm just showing you. Hopefully you can see what it is, because there's two other items. I think maybe there's a third that has that same exact print on it. So that way you can read it, I guess, better on these hats because it's up close. I don't know. But this week, it's just not it, at least for the beanie. There is a HQ piece that I think is kind of fire, but we'll get to that in a minute. Then we have the Knit Logo Crusher coming in four colorways, and these are just buns. Like, normal crushers sometimes do well, but with a knit one, I don't see it popping off. And I mean, if you were to get any, you gotta go the Gucci colorway right there, but overall, just kind of bland and lame. Next up, we have the Cotton Field Jacket coming in three colorways, and this one's kind of fire. Like, I dig the camo a lot. It has Supreme right there, and then it has Supreme on the back as well, and I think it pops off. Like, I think it does pretty well. I don't see anything being ridiculous. I think you'll make like 40 or 50 bucks at most, but again, I don't know the retail, so I can't say like, oh, this is going to sell for 250, because I don't know if it's going to be 200, but I think it should do all right, especially the camo. I don't think the other two colorways are going to have much profit. Then we have the HQ hooded sweatshirt coming in six colorways, and again, it has that Tokyo font writing that I showed you earlier on the hat. This one's all right. I don't really like this as much as the next one, next item coming up, but I think it's okay. So pretty much, it's just gonna sit pretty much for the US at least. I think in Japan it might sell out just because it's like targeted towards them, which if they did one for the US, I think it would be a cool idea. All right, so then we have the HQ Waffle Thermal coming in four colorways, and this is the one that I like the most out of the HQ collection, I guess. So you have Supreme right there, and then on the back you have that Supreme everything, like the Tokyo everything, the address, the number, the everything, pretty much. I think it does pretty well. I think you see resell $50 more than whatever the retail is, but nothing ridiculous. I think the black colorway is definitely the most profitable, and it's pretty fire. Again, if they did this for the US, I would probably go for this just because I think it's a really cool idea. So hopefully we see one of those in the future. Then we have the Iridescent Puffy Jacket coming in three colorways, and I've seen a lot of hype around this piece, but it's kind of dying off because people pretty much just bought their personal jackets last week. If you got a Voltero or something, I don't know the prices again on this, so I don't know how expensive it is compared to the North Face jackets, but I think this one's not gonna do as well as people thought. It's just not it. There is a Supreme spell out on the back, which is kind of clean, but again, it all depends on the prices, and the colorways are just not really that cool. I don't really dig it that much, but maybe you do. Then we have the afternoon camp cap, and this one's actually kind of clean. It's like this whole like painting on this hat. For me, again, I'm not a hat person, so I'm gonna let this sit. Resell, I don't really see it doing anything. I just think people like the design on it, so I still don't think it's gonna resell, but maybe you like it for the personal. Then we have these patchwork leather bags. So the first one is the patchwork leather small shoulder bag, and it's pretty clean. So it has all these different like pieces of leather like sewn together that look like Frankenstein pretty much. But for this one, I don't think the shoulder bag is gonna do as well as some of the other ones, just because it has a little extra pouch on the side. But honestly, it's not a bad piece to go for. Again, prices are probably gonna be through the roof just because it's leather and all that stuff. So maybe it might be a little too expensive for any resale. Then we're moving on, we have the patchwork leather duffel bag. And for me, I love this. I think duffel bags are so clean. And this one's actually super sick. It has like the Supreme Box logo. And I like that it's not in like red. Like I like that it's still black and leather. You do have a little red box logo on the shoulder strap, which I think is super nice. Again, price is probably gonna be through the roof. So not gonna go for personal. Maybe resell. But I don't see it doing anything ridiculous. And then we have the patchwork leather backpack. And this one's pretty cool too. It just, you can really see the patchwork design there on that one. And so you have that box logo in black, which is kind of cool. I think resale will probably be the best for this. I could see like $50 at most, maybe 60. Again, I don't know those prices, so I can't give you an exact number. And then we have the most hyped piece of the week, and that is the Stop Crying hooded sweatshirt. Coming in 6 colorways, and I actually dig this one a lot. So you have this like Supreme Box logo. It has a little something extra. I can't really see what it is, but that's on the side, and then on the back you have all these different words and different fonts. I wish they chose different colors for each one, but they kept it all the same. Unfortunately, they do curse a lot on it, which is kind of annoying because I do like the things that they're saying. I think it's edgy. I think it's kind of cool. I would probably have picked up the black one if it didn't curse or say the F word as much. For personal, but for resale, I actually do see this one doing all right. I think it'll probably be the best thing to go for this week. But again, there's other things you might want to go for personal or for resale. But overall, you're not going to get that much out of this week because it is a brick week. So yeah, that wraps it up. That is the brick week 11. That's what it is. Supreme, but maybe you can get in there, get some easy personals if you do see something you like. For everyone going for stuff tomorrow, good luck. I hope you don't get card decline and that the site is super nice and clean. No lags. Let's pray for that. And so yeah, have an awesome week and yeah, good luck tomorrow.